A milestone in China's ambitious space program. Three of its astronauts entered the country's space station Wednesday to kick off the first in-orbit crew rotation in Chinese space history. The astronauts arrived at the station after more than 6 hours of journey aboard the Shenzhou 15 spaceship. They were greeted with warm hugs from three colleagues who arrived there in early June and will return to Earth after a week-long handover period. The fresh crew will live on the station for 6 months. The Shenzhou 15 mission is the last of China's 11 missions needed to assemble the space station. At least three people are killed in southwest Pakistan from a suicide blast targeting the police. Wednesday's explosion in the city of Quetta was claimed by the Pakistan Taliban. It came after the militant group ended a ceasefire with government troops. Authorities say 23 other individuals were injured from that blast. Over the U.S., a Senate passes a landmark bill protecting same-sex and interracial marriage. The Respect for Marriage Act was approved 61-36 with support from all Democrats and 12 Republicans. The measure does not require states to legalize same-sex marriage, but it mandates them to recognize marriages performed in other states. House lawmakers are expected to pass their version of the bill next week before sending it to President Joe Biden for his signature. The bill's passage in the Senate comes amid concerns the Supreme Court could overturn a 2015 ruling that legalized same-sex marriage. The conservative-led court overturned the constitutional right to abortion back in June. The latest now in China, Beijing's top security body calls for a crackdown as widespread protests continue in major cities across the country. The Central Political and Legal Affairs Commission says it is necessary to prevent infiltration and sabotage activities by what it calls hostile forces. Authorities are trying to smother the growing dissent against the Chinese government's zero-COVID policy with heavy police presence in several cities. Universities have also sent students home to prevent even more demonstrations. Meanwhile, the International Monetary Fund warns it may have to slash China's growth forecasts following the unprecedented protests there. The IMF says the pandemic and problems in China's real estate sector continue to pose risks to the growth of the world's second largest economy. It expects China's economy to expand 3.2% this year, followed by a 4.4% growth in 2023. The IMF urges China to do away with its strict zero-COVID policy and shift to a more targeted response to avoid extensive damage to its economy. The Philippines' Ninoy Aquino International Airport is ranked the third most stressful airport in Asia and Oceania by travel blog Hawaiian Islands. That blog analyzed over 1,500 Google reviews in over 500 airports around the world to assess the stress level of passengers. Results showed nearly 58% of passengers who pass through Naia experience stress. Vietnam's Tan Son Nhat Airport was rated the most stressful, followed by the Sydney Kingsford Smith International Airport in Australia. Manila's airport authority vows to take immediate action to improve the experience of passengers.
We accept that, of course, we have different types of feedback, and we take this, meron tayong ganitong feedback regarding our airport in terms of the stress levels and, of course, the congestion. So, tanggapin naman po natin na meron tayong mga ganitong complaints. Pero ang pinaka-importante po ay ma-actionan natin at kung ano po yung kailangan natin gawin para ma-improve po ang ating passenger experience. Valid po yung observation. We cannot hide the fact that meron naman po talagang mga congestion at stress points ang ating Naia ngayon.